Well, the famous New Year's Eve Times Square ball got its crystals this morning. We were there as crews installed nearly 200 crystals on the ball, which contains more than 2,600 total. This year, a new design celebrates the gift of wisdom.
This year, we're installing the new Gift of Wisdom Waterford Crystal Triangles. The Gift of Wisdom is represented by a wheel with these petals of knowledge that are growing ever forward. People don't realize when you're looking at the ball on TV, you see these beautiful colors, the kaleidoscope effects. But if you get to be up close like we are today, you see these really beautiful, intricate Waterford patterns.
And you can see how big it is compared to him standing there, right? The New Year's Eve event in Times Square will go on this year, but with a much smaller crowd, and the city is requiring vaccinations and masks, all hoping for more health and happiness in 2022.
Fire burning in Times Square, but no firefighters are putting it out. That's because it's the 15th annual Good Riddance Day, the time to write down what you want to permanently leave behind from the last 12 months and literally burn it away.
I want to get rid of COVID and all the things that comes with it, you know, like loneliness.
Yep.
Quarantine, virtual teaching and learning, all the negative energy, the negative people.
In past years, participants shredded what they wanted to eliminate for the upcoming year, but instead, it's being lit on fire.
This is inspired by a Latin American tradition where they would burn life-size dolls to get rid of all the negativity of the previous year.
So for the first time here in Times Square, they got an incinerator. One man even brought his financial record, celebrating his financial freedom from debt. There's a whole wall of what people don't want to see next year, from ex-boyfriends to celebrities going to space and police brutality. Adrian Perry Ingram wants to get rid of his mother's cancer.
Four of us caught from COVID back in March. And we had to recover from that, but my mom had a difficult time doing it because she had asthma. So she ended up going to the hospital, and they did x-rays, and come to find out she actually had lung cancer.
Sarah Dean is an ICU nurse from Nashville and wants to get rid of iPads, the only form of contact she could provide to patients to see family one last time.
These people are very sick. We had no visitors, and we were their only family, whether it be 24 hours or 7 days, and it was awful.
It's a therapeutic way to say goodbye to all the hardships from the last 12 months and to start 2022 with a clean slate.